Hello. Today I'll be setting up a man-in-the-middle MITM proxy on Windows 11. The MITM's name is MITMproxy, appropriately enough. It's compact, trusted, open source, and I wrote about it in a 2021 post titled Packet Sniffing My LAN. Its UI has remained stable. Windows 11's crowning glory is its security consciousness. It doesn't let me install anything myself without first acknowledging several notices. I had to re-add this user account control screen because by default, it's too secure to capture. Windows 10 asked me about public and private networks fairly often. This is the first time Windows 11 has asked. I'm going to read this as the old Windows 10 question, where it defaults to select public network, as it does here, despite that being the less secure, and so the wrong choice for serious use. What Windows means by public network is Wi-Fi with no password, an insecure network. MITMproxy has already launched. We're not showing traffic for a couple of reasons. First, we have to create traffic with a request. I shut down my web browser completely, so no background tabs pollute our requests. I have a VM for demonstration purposes. I rearranged the windows to make it clear that requests aren't going to show up in our sniffer, MITMproxy. A 50-50 split looks good, but the guest edition's video driver's whining, or glitchy, display will persuade me to give it the whole screen. The fresh VM doesn't even have curl. I'll speed up these administrations. Curl works. Example.com responds. Let's make one more request. The weather from wttr.in. The proxy shows nothing. I press minus to switch the layout from flows to flows plus events. Or we can refer to MITMproxy's docs here. They tell us to test the proxy by browsing to mitm.it. We still see the same page everyone else does, and it links us to the official docs. Something else the docs tells us is to search for how to set the proxy for our particular OS. This hasn't changed between Windows 10 and 11. Network settings. Proxy. Manual proxy setup. User proxy server. The IP is localhost and port is 8080. This is in the docs and also the event pane of MITMproxy. I use the back button of my mouse to return to mitm.it. The third and final step awaits us here, instructing Windows to trust all certificates produced by MITMproxy. This is required to intercept TLS traffic, which almost all sites now require in 2024, whether we're sending any personal data or not. Like the BBC News will require it, for example. I download the certificate, and Windows knows exactly what to do when I open it. You wouldn't be here if you didn't understand the risks of adding a new certificate signing authority to Windows. I'll install for the local user, not machine-wide. I accept the defaults. There is no password. As for the certificate store, I want to know where it is installed to, in case I have to revoke it. I checked on two installations. The certificate is unique between installations. The serial number, subject key identifier, thumbprint, dates, all are unique. It is generated randomly by the downloaded MITMproxy executable. That doesn't guarantee the randomness is genuine. MITMproxy being open source is my assurance that the signing keys are indeed private. Thought, that's THAWTE, is in alphabetical order, despite being lowercase. I now know where to expect to see MITMproxy. No certificate there yet. There is the refresh button. When I select the newly installed certificate, I get a big red cross icon for deleting it. We must do this manually. Uninstalling MITMproxy, understandably, does not delete this root certificate for us. I restarted the MITMproxy window because it was polluted by browser traffic, which I also shut down. I want to isolate the effect of a single curl request. Still nothing in flow logs. That's surprising. VirtualBox is avoiding this proxy. It could be that Windows is respecting the VM as a true machine. More likely, it's that VirtualBox has created its own network adapter, which Windows hasn't claimed ownership of. The same request, only this time made from PowerShell, creates a flow entry in MITMproxy. I click on it, or press enter when the leftmost arrows are on it, and I get a detailed view. Common shortcut keys are displayed at the bottom, and a handful more can be found at any time by pressing the question mark key. Arrow keys and mouse clicks let me switch between the three tabs, request, response, and detail. The response hasn't been formatted nicely. Let's try example.com. At least ASCII art reproduction won't matter there. When I tried to select part of the response with a mouse, I'm told I need to hold either function, alt, shift, or control. I try this, but there is no way to scroll the page once I'm dragging. It works for smaller responses, somewhat. About 1 in 5 line breaks didn't copy. At least they didn't in Windows. I'm sure Linux would be more fruitful. The shortcut keys at the bottom offer better solutions that can result in a lot of typing. I'll just save all outputs to the root of my D drive for now. Save body B saves the whole response. Formatted nicely. I can export the request needed to generate any given response by pressing X. Here I'm going with the curl format. It's not clear to me what the others represent. I would have liked to have seen better support for the Python requests library. I initiated this response from curl, and it didn't require any of the optional headers. Probably they were supplied as default by my implementation. Let's try raw. This looks pure HTTP format. Still, the ASCII art is mucked up. I can blame Windows for this. That's how we inspect and capture requests and responses. The real power of this software is its ability to alter or fiddle them. I initiate creation of an intercept. --u simply makes the filter match the subsequent regex against the URL. Let's reissue the last request for London weather, but intercept it. No response. The proxy has triggered, like a breakpoint. We need to intervene when the flow is read. You'll notice the right-hand side of the flow row is empty. Pressing A resumes the flow. The response details appear in the right-hand side. The response hasn't arrived in our requesting terminal just yet, though. This is because the regex intercept is matching both the request and the response. Just hitting A a second time progresses the response to the client. Let's repeat. This time we fiddle the request. On the intercepted flow, hit E and choose path. Press enter again to edit the only path parameter, London. Let's make it Paris. We can see the request has changed and no response has been observed. Another request has lodged in the flow logs. It uses HTTPS, which serves as a convenient demonstration of how even that can be intercepted with MITMproxy once its root certificate is trusted by Windows. I tap A twice to allow the modified request to return the weather in Paris. It's 3 degrees cooler there. I can only have one intercept at a time, so I set the filter to not capture responses with tilde Q and repeat my request. I still need to press A after modifying the request, but just once, as the response isn't intercepted. Another result as surprising as the VM avoiding the proxy, Glasgow is 2 degrees warmer than London. To prove the general effectiveness of the proxy, Here are some more sniffed flows. All of these are from Windows 11 and Edge. I was working on a different computer while these were collected. MITMproxy only captures HTTP-based traffic. This includes HTTPS, WSS, that's secure web sockets, and protobuf. Other layer 7 protocols and lower level socket servers are ignored. I tried another VM, a text only one provisioned by Vagrant. It too was able to circumvent my proxy. In Windows, with the proxy configured in network settings, I can't even reach the web without MITMproxy serving the proxied port 8080. VirtualBox, by default and by my instruction, creates network adapters on the host. These are on different subnets to the gateway-facing adapter. This would explain why its VMs are able to skirt around my proxy. The VM demonstrated here was configured in my previous video. Thank you for watching.